Oh my god. Wait, you look so good.
I can't believe it's been over a year now since we started the flip. I honestly have learned so much throughout this entire process, and it's been absolutely crazy to think that we are officially in the final stretch of making this house. There's no one else I'd rather be doing this process with than Manuel and Kathy and their entire team. It's also been so fun sharing this entire journey with you guys, so get ready because we're almost done turning this hoarder house into someone's dream home.
Guess what came in the mail?
I'm so excited. Hi guys, it's Tiffany. What is freaking up, you guys? I know it's been a minute since I've given you guys an update on the house, but in my defense, things are just not going according to plan, and I haven't been posting as many updates as I would like to, but the house is on the market. This video I'm about to show you guys, I filmed a few months ago. You guys know, the market with real estate is absolutely insane. It's not going according to how I would like it to go, but I will say I've enjoyed this entire process so much. So this is actually going to be the last video I show you guys before I show you guys the entire full house tour. So get excited for that. But right now I'm excited because my Love Bonito clothing just came in the mail. I'm in love with their clothing. It's so freaking cute, and I thought I would do a little haul for you guys. It honestly feels really weird to be vlogging because I feel like I haven't properly vlogged in months. I don't even know how to vlog anymore. I feel like I haven't really updated you guys on my life unless you guys watch me on my podcast, which is ROTN Podcast. There is no other way I've been really updating you guys. And so I thought we would just maybe talk and chat for a little bit before you guys see what's going on with the house. Oh my god, I'm so excited for this stuff. And yes, today's video is sponsored by Love Bonito. They are a brand where their silhouettes and their clothing actually fit people of my stature. So if you're like a petite Asian girl, or you're just a petite person in general, I highly recommend this brand. All of their clothing is supposed to fit petite women. Oh my god, this is so, I can tell this is like actually perfect for someone petite. And when I say these pieces are made for like Asian women, you don't have to be Asian to support them, but a lot of the colors they use are supposed to be for more golden and olive undertones because it is an Asian brand. I don't know if you guys can tell, the quality is just so beautiful. Okay, I will be wearing this to the podcast. This is such a cute outfit. I love that everything is just nicely tailored to my size. Whenever I ever wear blazers, the freaking arms, man. The sleeves are always so long, but this is like the perfect amount of sleeves. I don't know, I feel like such a boss. Remember how I said I love work outfits because I feel like such a boss in them? This next outfit I'm gonna wear is with these trousers and a white blazer to match it. Honestly, they have more than just workwear clothes, by the way. They have like really cute party dresses, intimates, maternity, if you guys are pregnant. But let's try on this next outfit. What? The pants actually fit me. I cannot tell you guys how many times I have to hem pants, even though it says it's for petite people, because they never freaking fit me. Look at this. Out of the box, straight out of the bag. I don't have to tie it. Nothing. I'm so happy with these. I now want to try on this top. I'm obsessed with a sweater. I didn't even realize this comes with thumb holes. That is just an extra touch you need when you're wearing clothes to make it a lot more comfortable. Guys, you are sleeping on Love Bonito if you guys are my size. They definitely know what they're doing there. All right, the next outfit I have, again, another modest outfit. I don't know why, I've just been gravitating towards the modest outfits, and I promise you guys, not all their pieces are super modest, but let's try her on. Okay, the dress is on. I love like the little slit. I don't know if you guys can see the little slit at the very bottom, right in the middle. Because with these mini dresses, if you don't have the slit here, I feel like you have to like shuffle everywhere. But I don't have to do that with this. I just love that there's like this little tie, so it makes your waist look even smaller so you can snatch it in really fast. Last thing I want to try on is this jacket. I got this in a size large actually, but this is just a beautiful oversized bomber with fur all over it, and on the inside it's like it's lined with pleather. And I'm gonna try it on with this black and white turtleneck right here. Let's put it on. Okay, jacket and the top is on with the same trousers I was wearing earlier. I don't know why, I just feel so cute when I'm so modest like this. All right, so I just checked online. This jacket's actually $68, which is such a reasonable price. This thing is such great quality. And they also have it in another color. I think I wanna get it in the mint green as well, just because this feels so comfortable.
So yeah, if you guys wanna upgrade your closet with clothes that are made to fit literally your body, if you guys are anything like me, I'll have a link for you guys down below to check out Love Bonito. I also have a promo code for you guys. That's LBX MissTiffanyMa, and that is good for 10% off with orders over $130.
I'm actually headed to the house right now to talk to Manuel, but I'm excited that you guys are about to see what the house is going to look like. It has come together so well. Everything I imagined has just been vomited into this house, and it's beautiful, and the stagers did an incredible job on it. And I know some of you guys have already saw the listing, but please don't go to the listing unless you guys are actually interested in buying a house, because I don't want the real estate agents to be overwhelmed with me, because they already are. Yeah, with that being said, this is the last video before you guys get to see the entire thing, so get excited. Hello guys, I just went to Target. I bought a bunch of Halloween candy because I have been wanting to give all the workers a little like Halloween trick-or-treating bag because we're almost done with the house. I've been so thankful for everyone helping me out. Today's pretty much almost the last day we are building the house or finishing up the house. I haven't been in the house for 3 days, so much has been done. Today's one of the last days. Unfortunately, I've been super busy the last 2 days with other things I've been working on. So I'm gonna make a little Halloween bag for everyone. We got a lot of candy. So I bought these sandwich bags that says Boo on it because unfortunately they did not have any like Halloween treat bags left. Butterfingers, Ritz bars. We got a bunch of gummy bears. Almond Joys. I know a lot of people don't like Almond Joys, but I'm not gonna lie, I freaking love them. I used to think they were like the worst candy ever until I finally tried it as an adult, and they're so good. Also, Butterfingers are Matt's favorite candies, so I got these as well. But I think I'm gonna make like 20 bags. Hopefully that's enough. And then if I have any extras, I'm gonna make extra little goodie bags for all the delivery workers, because you guys know like I get a lot of packages. So I'm gonna open up all the bags and just mix everything together and just kind of go from there. You guys need to see this. Look at this giant mound of candy. I'm so sad because in my neighborhood, kids don't walk around in trick-or-treat. My neighborhood I live in is like a very much a retirement neighborhood. Everyone who lives here is really old. They don't have families or anything. But I'm gonna mix this and make a bunch of bags. Workers and the delivery workers who come by every day. All right, I put about 8 in every single one, which I think is a good amount. Look at that, guys. Time to put them in this cute little Spotify creator bag that I got. Goodbye, fridge. We are returning you. So I handed out all the candy. I think I have like 2 bags left. There's so many workers today, which is so good that I have so much candy, but now I need to buy more for all the mailmen. That's okay. It was actually really fun making it.
Hello, beautiful house. I'm sad I didn't see her get installed. Oh, look how pretty. Are you kidding me? I'm sorry. Are you kidding me? This is beautiful. So beautiful.
Right, so we just picked up food and had lunch at the house, but I wanted to show you guys the new countertops that came in. They look absolutely incredible. Gorgeous. I kind of don't want to show you guys it, but at the same time, I want to show you guys it. I want to keep it a surprise, but it's too pretty not to show you guys. So, you guys ready to see the countertops?
Are you kidding me? Did I show you guys this already? I cannot remember. Okay, I already showed you guys this. I don't know what I was thinking. I thought I didn't show it to you guys. So here is the kitchen. And then if we head over to this room. So we had our cabinet guy come in and take measurements. We're gonna add a custom shelving in this room. And then here is our bathtub. And with the little cloth feet and everything, I've always wanted a clawfoot bathtub. So I'm very jealous of whoever buys this house. It's gorgeous. And then We added the fixtures. We are not as ready as I was hoping.
We called the stager and we actually pushed back the staging for an extra 3 days. So today's Wednesday. We were supposed to get the house staged by tomorrow. That kind of sucks. And I don't even know if we'll be ready with the extra 3 days as well, because the cabinet guy still hasn't finished everything yet. He needs to finish everything, but super nice guy.
So all the workers today have just been painting, touching everything up. We still have yet to paint the bathroom because we keep going back and forth, but that is gonna happen, of course. They're just like, you'll see them outside. Here, let me show you guys. We're finishing up the deck as well and the garage. They added the door into the garage right here and a little concrete step. And I'll show you guys the front of the house because they finally added the concrete to the front as well. Guys, we're outside to show you guys that we finally concreted the driveway, and then we also have concrete here as well. It's currently covered because we don't want to get it dirty since they're still working, but they added all this concrete and you can see it underneath these papers or this cardboard. So it is currently concreted, although it doesn't look like it. Also, we're gonna trim the trees a little bit because you kind of have to duck to get underneath the trees. And then they have finished the outside, so we are painted it white. We're almost done. It looks incredible. I don't remember if you guys saw it or not, but this window accidentally got cracked. So we also fixed it, which is amazing. It was a very expensive window to fix and a very expensive window to purchase. So hopefully this doesn't happen again. How many workers does it take to carry this giant stove? 4. It is so heavy. Manuel has too much fun doing this. Is this the Japanese maple wood?
Yeah. Oh, this is gorgeous.
This one's really pretty.
All right, guys, so I'm at the house. I don't want to show you guys too much, but I know the bathroom has been a big debate for you guys, either going light or dark, what is it? I wanted to show you guys what we ended up doing. We still need to fix it, but it looks so good. Okay, you guys ready?
All right, here we are. It looks so good. It's kind of hard to see in this lighting, but there is like a slight shade of green. It's very subtle, but I actually do like it. Originally I was like, I want it more green, but I kind of like that it's dark. It really matches the black. Here's everything. We still need to install the vanities. And then right now, if we do the baseboards black, we're also gonna paint this framing black. We're trying to figure out if we actually want the inside of the bathroom black as well, because now it looks very sterile compared to this room.
So today is Saturday. We were supposed to be done by Monday. Now we are thinking we're gonna be ready by Wednesday. So the stagers are coming on Wednesday instead. She actually just stopped by today and was like, honestly, if you guys need more time, I can give you guys more time because I also need more time. We're like, yes, both of us need more time, so let's just do it. So we have an extra 2 days to finish everything up. I have a quick business trip to New York City on Wednesday, which is the day the stagers come, but Manuel and Kathy will be here making sure everything goes right. Kind of sad I'm missing it, but I really have to go to New York for this trip.
Oh, also I forgot. We also are gonna add a glass door as well. This is not gonna just sit here like this, and that will happen very soon. So there are a few more things we need to finish up, but so far I'm really loving the look of it. It's very moody. It has a lot of personality in this room. We have our little soap dish right here. We'll probably add a little stool right here so someone can like do their makeup or whatever. Or if like a kid wants to go to the bathroom with his parents, they can have like a little stool so they can brush their teeth with their parents. So cute. But yeah, we're just cleaning up the entire house right now and just waiting for the cabinet guy to bring everything else. Also, here is how the concretes are looking for the backyard. Instead of adding grass, we thought about it. If a car is like running over it quite often, we're gonna actually add a little bit of rock so it matches the front of the house as well, because we're just doing rocks in the front.
Hello guys, it is crunch time. We've been working on it nonstop the last couple of days. I just haven't been vlogging it because it's very stressful. I've also just been stressed out with a lot of other things happening in my life right now. Tomorrow the stagers come by and literally staged the entire house. So we are making sure the house is completely clean. We took out the gate in the front, and I'm not going to show you guys everything because you guys have already seen it a million times. So I'm not going to show you guys anything on the inside of the house. I will show you guys the outside of the house because it's beautiful. We finally took away the gate, like the little gate surrounding the house. So it looks really good. And I'm going to make you guys wait to see the house fully furnished and everything this weekend. So let's head on in.
So the gate's gone. Look at this. So pretty. Look at all the flowers. Wow.
Okay, it's too dark to film the inside, but I'll show you guys the outside. Ah! Oh my god, the grass is in. The grass is in.
Holy cow. Holy cow. That is beautiful. Look how beautiful. All right, here's the front yard. So of course we're cleaning things up a little bit, but look how beautiful it looks. Oh my goodness. Look at all the trees. We have a Japanese maple right here. Blue cypress, right? Blue cypress. All these other trees, they look so good. I'm so happy with how they look. So we are still gonna take this pole out. This is not gonna stay here forever, but we still need electricity and stuff. But I promise it's not gonna be here. We have so many colors in the backyard. All these bougainvilleas are just like this hot pink color. It's gonna be so pretty when they grow out, and we're gonna stick them in these pots. So don't worry, they're gonna go in these pots. We just have all these shrubs. Also, the grass is officially in. But the coolest thing is about this is that when you walk onto the deck and you hang out here, all these trees right here block the view of your car. So you can park your car here if you want to. It won't take away from the backyard at all. It feels very private and nice back here. Like, this is such a private looking backyard. I'm actually shocked at how well it turned out. We are still adding on the railing for the deck because we do have like a little fence so no one falls off, but we'll probably get that done right before we actually start doing open houses, but it probably won't be ready for the photos we're taking on Wednesday. So pretty. Also, we got the garage door in. I'll close it later so you guys can see it. Oh my gosh, this house is amazing. All right, so we're back at the front of the house. Look how cute. This is so cute. All these lavenders, how beautiful. Also, all these violets.
Wait, actually, I don't want to look. I looked. Uh-oh.
One second.
Oh my god, wait, it looks so good.
Wait, this is like
such a cute room. Wait, the stagers are amazing. So it's really dark in this house, so I'm not gonna show you guys a full tour until it's brighter inside. It's just been really rainy these last few days, and so it's not the same if I show it to you guys while it's dark, but I'm literally beyond happy with how the stagers did. I'm like, actually, like, I never use the word flabbergasted, but I wanna say I'm flabbergasted. Like, I am shocked. I thought I was good at like styling homes and like my house and stuff. Like, this is on a whole other level. Like, they absolutely killed it. They were also not very expensive to hire to stage the house. This living room might be my favorite living room I've ever seen, ever. I will have to show you guys that later, but good luck to the new homeowners because I don't think they'll be able to match like this energy. Because I remember when I bought my house, I was so in awe of the stagers, and I've been trying to mimic it and still have yet to get it looking as good as they did. So excited for whoever moves into this house. So hi guys, I just got back from the house. As you guys can tell, the house is beautiful. I just talked to Manuel for a little bit because I needed some updates from him. I don't want to update you guys because I'll tell you guys in another video because I'm kind of behind right now, but we have some updates. But with that being said, I just wanted to say a huge thank you to everyone who's been following this entire journey with the flip. I know everything has been all over the place. I've been doing this for over a year now. I can't believe I've had this house for over a year and I've learned a freaking lot, okay? I do want to do like a complete video about real estate and my first experience. So if you guys have any questions, please leave them down below. I'm going to gather all the questions and maybe do like a Q&A when I do my final update on the house. But I love you guys. If you guys haven't already, check out Love Bonito. I'll have a link for you guys down below. I love you guys. Bye guys. Bye.
Hey, you the best part of every single day. Oh, no matter what I do, I'll be lost in you.